بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه، علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما، أخرجنا من ظلمات الوهم وأكرمنا بنور الفهم، وأنعم علينا يا عظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. My brothers and sisters in Islam, after the praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace be upon His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I testify that there is no God but Allah, and I testify that Muhammad is the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make tonight's lesson as a guidance for a lot of people to be guided. And I ask Allah azza wa jal to strengthen our knowledge through tonight's lesson. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us understand the meaning of tonight's lesson. We are still in the journey of the hereafter, talking about the Day of Judgment. After we spoke about the minor and the major signs, to start with the Day of Judgment, with the first blow, نفخة الصعق, نفخة الفزع, then the second blow, نفخة الصعق, and then third blow, نفخة البعث. For the third blow, the blow of resurrection, all mankind will come forward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all gathered on a different earth and heaven, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرُ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ. The day that the earth will exchange to a different earth and to a different heaven, an earth that's got no mountains, no rivers or trees, an earth that no sins had been committed on, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could judge people with full justice. And then people are in crowds, the crowds of the believers and the crowds of the non-believers. And then people will be with those ones they followed in this world. They'll be with those ones they loved and followed in this world. People will be looking at those ones who they followed in this world, who deceived them in this world, saying, aren't you going to save us from this time? Didn't you say that you are Lord? Didn't you say that you are Creator? Didn't you say that you have powers? Didn't you say that you have strength? Save us. So they look around and they say, we need someone to save us. At that time, where people will disown the closest people to them, they'll disown their children, disown their parents, mother and father, disown their brothers, disown their wives, disown their brothers and everyone, and run away from everyone. The only word and the only ones that speak are the prophets. They saying, Allahumma sallim, sallim, Ya Allah, make it easy, Ya Allah, make it easy. Everyone is waiting. Everyone's waiting for their judgment. Everyone is waiting for their questioning time. Everyone is waiting for their destination. And as we said last week, there'll be people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to be under His shadow, where there's no shadow except His shadow. And we mentioned those people. And the rest of the other people, they'll be under the sun. They'll be under the sun. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the sun will be less than a mile above the heads of people. People will be sweating and crying, that they'll drown from the sweat and tears. People will be crying, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the water will reach up to their knees, and some to their hips, and some to their breasts, and some will cover them the water fully. Everyone is waiting for their destination. That the non-believers, those ones who are under the sun, will wish they'll be casted in the hellfire than being in that time or than being in that position they are in. They wish to be thrown in the hellfire than being in the position they are in. But the believers are under the throne of Allah. The believers are under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everyone is waiting. At that time, as I said, everyone will be in crowds, naked, barefooted. The way the mom gave birth to them, that like the day their mom gave birth to them. When Aisha heard that, she told them a proverb of Allah. Wouldn't people look at each other? So sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O Aisha, the matter is much bigger and greater than people perving at each other. Everyone's waiting for Allah. So at that time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends down. First of all, the angels of the first heaven will descend down. Their number and population is it as twice as the number and the population of the human beings and the jinn on earth. And don't forget that time will be the jinn and the humans from the day that Allah Azza wa Jalla created them all the way to the day of judgment. See that great number of people? The angels will descend down from the first heaven. Twice as the number and population of the people and the jinn on earth. So when people see that, they say, is Allah among you? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descending down with you? So they say no. So the angels of the first heaven will surround the creation of Allah on earth. They'll surround the human beings and the jinn on earth. And then the angels of the second heaven will descend down. The angels of the second heaven will descend down. Their number is as twice as the number. Not this time, the jinn and the ins, even the angels that are around the human beings. Their number will be twice as number as them. And same thing with the angels of the third heaven. They'll descend down. Their number is as twice as the number. The human beings and the jinn. And the angels of the first heaven and the angels of the second heaven, the angels of the third heaven is twice as the number of these four. Allahu Akbar. Is that all? No, then the angels of the fourth heaven will descend down. Their number is as twice as the number of the humans and the jinn and the angels of the first and the second and the third heavens. Their number will be twice as the number of them. And it goes to the fifth heaven. Until the sixth heaven, until the seventh heaven. Every heaven is as twice as the number of the people existing and the creation of Allah existing on earth. From the human and the jinn and the angels. Allahu Akbar. How many angels does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have? Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he went in the Isra wal Mi'raj, when he went in the Mi'raj to the seventh heaven, he met his grandfather Ibrahim leaning his back to the Kaaba. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or the Kaaba, the Bayt al-Ma'mur in the seventh heaven, is the Kaaba of the creation of the heavens, the angels of the heavens. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that I saw Ibrahim leaning his back to the Bayt al-Ma'mur. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that every day Allah creates 70,000 new angels to go around the Bayt al-Ma'mur and never come back to it. 70,000 angels every single day being created by the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah jalla jalla. And then sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ, that no one knows the soldiers of Allah except Allah. No one knows the soldiers of Allah except Allah. Here are people waiting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to descend down. So the angels of the first heaven will descend down. Then the angels of the second heaven will descend down. Then the angels of the third heaven and then the fourth heaven and then the fifth heaven and the sixth and the seventh heaven. And everyone is just paying attention. وَخَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلرَّحْمَانِ فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسًا. All the voices humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are only He whispering. وَعَنَتِ الْوُجُوهُ لِلْحَيِّ الْقَيُّومِ. All the faces and their foreheads are up, humbling themselves for Allah azza wa jal. Humbling themselves for their Lord.